Infrastructure is a perennial issue in Indonesia, as much in the Far East, where roads and lines of communications are sparse, as in Jakarta, where the confluence of inadequate planning and endless stream of new people and new vehicles have created a nightmare of traffic and floods.
Deputy Transportation Minister Bambang Susantono has an viable job in some respects. He sat down with our senior editor, Bimanto Suwastoyo.
Hello, my name is Bimanto, and you're watching Indonesia Highlights Interview. With us today, we have Pak Bambang Susantono, the Deputy Minister for Transportation. Good day to
Pak.
You, and yes. I hope you didn't have too much traffic to come here.
Traffic is always here.
We would like to talk about several transportation issues that are actually topical this day, because we have the Ramadan coming up.
Yes.
And everybody's talking about the double rail track.
Mm-hmm.
Information are rather confusing. Is it completed? Are they usable by the time the Ramadan exodus is on? Or where is it at the present stage?
At this point, we already finished the Jakarta until Surabaya, but Surabaya not going into the direct in the city centers.
Outside the city center?
Not outside, it's already Surabaya. It's sort of like if in Jakarta you have a Jatinegara.
Ah, right. Okay.
So between Jatinegara
and Gambir. Station.
Not the Gambir one, at the Pasar Turi, but on Jatinegara.
Right.
So the remaining is only about 8 kilometers, which from 8 kilometers, only 300 meters is still under construction to be finished, because of the land acquisition that a bit slow.
Yeah.
So we have to finish that. But the operations of the railway from Jakarta Surabaya, 727 kilometer, has already followed what we call the new timetable for the railway itself. So from 1st of June, it's already there. I mean that the operation is already mm-hmm. using the double track schemes.
Yeah? By how much does the travel time got cut?
If we have a simple calculations, if you have one,
yeah.
then everything that has to use that kind of track has to
you
wait.
Have to wait,
right?
Yeah.
But now, when you have two, one goes there, one goes here, so that at least two, at least double. But if we can increase the frequency by shortening the headways,
the
time between one train to another train, then we may jump up to about three times actually.
Do we have the fleet to do that?
That's really the concern right now.
Ah.
So we have as much as possible now to try to increase the frequencies
mm-hmm.
by shortening the time.
The train? The
travel time. Yeah,
the
travel time. And adding about less than 10 new trains, actually, right? So by that situation, we already increase the frequency itself, right?
By how many percent in terms of passenger, for example? We all know that Ramadan is like the time when nobody can get tickets at the last time. How would this double track plus the additional train add in terms of passenger load, for example?
Passengers, at least now we are able to carry about 130% of the normal one.
Of the normal rate?
Yes.
Wow, that's
right?
A lot.
For the Lebaran things, I think that this is the time when we in the Ministry of Transportation is very busy.
time.
About the 30 million people, can you imagine that? 30 million people at least will travel in the same time, in almost the same route, because most of them are going to Jawa.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And most of them are using the private vehicles, right?
At the same time?
At the same time.
Wow.
30 million is more than people in Malaysia
or people
in Australia, you know. So for that reason, we are mobilizing all the public transportations in order for us to decrease the vehicles on the street. Basically, that's what we are going to do, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That for that also, we, for example, almost 350 train we are mobilizing, 430 aircraft for the airplane.
Yeah.
About 17,000 buses around the countries.
Yeah. How many motorcycles?
Motorcycles is another headache, because again, about 2.5 million people will use that.
Yeah.
And basically, they are traveling from Jakarta to Central Java. Central Java is the point where most of them are going to go, right? So for that reason, in order for us to increase the safety level, we are trying to decrease or to facilitate those who are using the motorcycle by four things. First, we are facilitate them by providing the what we call the ships.
The cargo thing.
Yes, not the cargo, the motorcycle.
Oh, the roll and roll, roll on, roll off.
Yes, ferry roll and roll, roll on and roll off. That's number one. All second right. one is the normal ships, the passenger ships.
Passenger ship.
Between Jakarta Semarang and then also Jakarta Surabaya and Jakarta Panjang on Lampung. The third one, about 6,000 capacity for motorcycles on the train.
All right.
And about 10,000 capacity for the motorcycle that will be transported by bus and truck. So the passenger goes to the bus and the motorcycle goes to the
truck. Get to the truck.
And they go, for example, to point in Central Java, like Tegal, Purwokerto.
Right, Solo. Distribution point,
yes.
basically.
Yes.
Right.
And luckily, we have a survey. 15,000 households. We are surveying throughout the Indonesia, so we know the tendencies, we know the trend, how they will going in Lebaran, what time they are going, how many passengers they are going, and using what kind of modes of transportation they will go in the Lebaran festivals.
We're taking a break now, and we'll be back shortly.